We begin tonight with a stunning development in the death of a little girl earlier this year near Toowoomba. 8-year-old Elizabeth Struhs died after her parents allegedly denied her medication for type 1 diabetes. Today, a dozen people from a religious group were arrested and also charged with murder. Police say every single one of them stood by and watched her die, believing God would ultimately save her.
At dawn, police intervened to arrest those they say didn't, while 8-year-old Elizabeth Rose Struhs suffered and died, allegedly left in the hands of God rather than paramedics who were called more than a day later.
The reason why that we're here this morning is I have a warrant that's been issued under the Police Powers and Responsibilities Act to search this dwelling in relation to property, OK?
At Homestead Avenue in Harrisville, just down the road from where the little girl was found dead in January, a dozen people believed to be disciples of a fundamentalist religious group comprised of three families were taken into custody.
I'm from the Lely Child Protection Investigation Unit. The time now is 6:37 on the 5th of July 2022. We're now placing you under arrest for murder.
We're going to place you under arrest for the murder of...
Elizabeth's parents, Kerry and Jason Struhs, have already been charged with murder, torture and failing to provide the necessities of life. Police say the group joined them to pray for the little girl who was denied treatment for a diabetic condition for almost a week.
We're aware of the child's condition. We're present during the course of those 6 days at the Rangeville address and did not take any steps to provide medical assistance to the child.
Horrified neighbours had no idea the music and fellowship taking place at the house was hiding something so sinister.
It seemed like they were doing it just after Christmas to have a Christmas party. A couple of cars showed up and they were out in there talking and singing and all that stuff with guitars and music and stuff like that. Didn't think of anything of it, to be honest.
6 months of investigation by detectives, forensic teams and the Child Protection Branch followed.
It's a very complex investigation. And I'm not aware of a similar event in Queensland, let alone Australia.
All 12 charged are expected to be named in court tomorrow. Chris Campy for 10 News First.